Hi, good evening.
Good
Hello.
evening, teacher.
How are you?
I'm fine. And you?
I'm fine too. Thank you, Jasmine. How was your day?
Today was
Okay, just fine. That's good. Was it busy? ¿Estuvo ocupado su día?
A little,
okay. Nice. Did you have any time to work in the platform? ¿Tuvo tiempo de trabajar en plataforma? Un poquitín.
I was working in on the afternoon. In this moment, I am in 1:15.
Okay, that's good. Very nice, Jasmine. Let's see. Hello, Jason. How are you?
Hello, teacher. So.
So?
I feel a little sick.
Oh, really? That's so bad.
Yes.
What's the matter?
Headache.
Oh, you have a headache. Yeah, that's so bad.
Yes.
So, was your day busy? Did you have to work or study or anything?
Study because the Thursday I have a evaluation.
Oh, okay. You have an evaluation on Thursday. Okay.
Yes, but I'm here.
Yeah, that's good.
I'm here ready.
Nice. Let's see, Jose Arturo. Good evening. How are you?
I'm good. I feel so tired, but
okay.
I'm here.
Yeah. You had a day of work today. Is it hard?
So hard, very busy.
I can imagine. Did you have any time to work in the platform?
Yes.
Yes? What section are you in?
Four.
Section four already. Yeah. Great.
Yes.
Well, that's nice. You're almost done.
Yeah.
Cool. Good evening, Karen.
Hi, good evening. How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
Fine too, thank you.
Excellent. How was your day?
Very good. With my son, my house.
Oh yeah, that's fine. Nice. Mm-hmm. Did you have any time to work in the platform today?
I finished it.
Oh, you finished. Nice.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
That's great. Did you get the diploma?
No, still not. This week, me dijeron que iba a hacer esta semana.
Oh, okay. That's good. All right, excellent. Let's see. Thank good you. Evening, Isabel.
Hi.
How are you, Isabel? Sorry, Isabel, I cannot hear you.
I am great. And
okay.
You?
Great. I'm doing well, thanks. So how was your day? Was it good?
Yes.
Okay. Was it busy? Did you have a lot to do?
Yes.
A lot of homework, or do you work?
Homework.
Just homework, okay. All right, that's nice, Isabel. Good evening, Noemi.
Good evening, teacher. Good evening.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Nice. How was your day?
I'm working.
Okay, it was busy, maybe. Did you have any
exhausted?
Oh yeah, I can imagine. So
yes,
did you have any time to work in the platform?
Thank you.
Noemi, did you have any time to work in the platform? ¿Tuvo tiempo de trabajar en plataforma?
Voy a trabajar a partir de ahora por solo he trabajado en 12 ejercicios.
Ok.
Porque no he tenido tiempo, pero yo me pongo las pilas, yo sé.
All right, don't worry, I understand it. Hi, Mauricio. Good evening.
Hi, Miss. How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
Fine, fine. Thanks.
Excellent. So how was your day?
Good. Today was a good day.
All right, that's nice. Did you have any time to work in the platform?
Sorry, teacher, I can do working in the platform today.
Oh, okay, that's fine. So don't worry, I understand there are some busy days and there are some others in which we can take some time and work in the platform and stuff, but don't worry, okay? Just keep going.
Yes, I promise I work.
All right,
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, I promise. I promise I work in the platform this week.
Okay, that's good. Hi, Roberto.
Thanks.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
How are you?
I'm fine, teacher. And you?
Excellent. I'm doing well. Thank you. Did you have any time to work in the platform, Roberto?
Yes, teacher.
Yes? What section? You finished with everything.
Yeah, you finished.
Oh, that's great.
Thank you.
That's very nice. Okay, so I think we are ready to start. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay, good.
Yes.
So we are going to start. Tell me. Okay. So first of all, let me know if you have any doubts. No sé si tenemos alguna duda, alguna pregunta de la plataforma o de algún ejercicio.
Yes. When I was working in the platform, me surgió una duda. I don't know when I was when I have to use I or when I have to use I. What is the difference?
When you have to use, sorry, what was that? ¿Cuáles son las palabras?
Me and I.
Me and I. Okay, en esos casos cuando es el sujeto, es decir, cuando nosotros somos los que estamos realizando la acción, la actividad de la que estamos hablando, usamos I. I work hard. Yo trabajo. Soy yo la que estoy haciendo las cosas, right? I work. I drink water. Yo tomo agua. I'm doing that. I drink. I use my cell phone. Yo uso mi teléfono. En todas estas oraciones, soy yo la que está haciendo dicha acción. And then, in the case of me, the action goes to me. I am not doing it. But I am just taking the, like, the reaction, let's say. En ese caso, no soy yo la que estoy haciendo las cosas, sino que, digamos que recaen sobre mí. For example, you love me. You love me. Usted me quiere a mí. You love me. Entonces, en ese caso, no soy yo la que quiere, sino que es la otra persona, right? Or when you say, let's see, let me see.
Why me?
Why me, right? ¿Por qué yo? In that case, why me? ¿Por qué yo? right? Or when you say, for example, let me see, déjeme ver, right? So I don't know if it's clear now. No sé si quedamos un poquito más claros. Yes. Okay.
Yes,
thank you. Sí, entonces siempre piensen en el hecho de que si yo estoy haciendo la acción, si yo soy la que la está realizando, utilizo I. Y en los otros casos donde la acción recae en mí, utilizo me. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Any other questions? Maybe not. Okay. So let's start with this little exercise for remembering about feel and have. So I'm going to give you a subject like this and either a noun or an adjective. And then you are going to choose feel or have and make a sentence. For example, this one, I feel or I have terrible. What do I say?
I feel
terrible, right? Okay, next one, Jose Arturo.
He have.
Okay, just remember for the third person we use
He has
an earache. Okay. Okay, very good. He has an earache. Next one, Jasmine.
They feel angry.
Very good. They feel angry. Next one, Noemi.
I feel sad.
Excellent. We have another one for Jason.
She feels anxious.
She feels anxious. Very good, Jason.
Anxious.
Okay, our next one is for Roberto.
We have a sore throat.
Very good. Next one is for Mauricio.
Okay. In my knee.
Okay, very good. I have a pain in my knee. Very good, Mauricio. Next one is for Isabel.
We feel confused.
Exactly, we feel confused. Very good. Next one, Karen Quintanilla.
Okay. You feel terrific.
Very good. You feel terrific. Excellent. Okay, very good. So you remember feel and have pretty well. Just remember the third person. Solo recordar la tercera persona para feel, feels, y para have, has. Feels for he, she, it. Has for he, she, it. Okay, now let's talk a little bit about common medication. So you have watched the video and you have found some of the most common medications that are antacid, aspirin, muscle cream, cough syrup, cough drops, cold pills, eye drops, acetaminophen, and ibuprofen, for instance. Tenemos los medicamentos como un poco más comunes, que serían estos. Now I need you to repeat.
Antacid.
Aspirin.
Aspirin.
Muscle cream.
Muscle cream.
Cough syrup.
Cough syrup.
cough syrup.
Cough
drops.
Cough drops.
Cold pills.
Cold pills.
Cold pills.
Eye drops.
Eye drops.
Acetaminophen.
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 Ibuprofen.
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 Okay, so do you have any questions about any of those medications? No sé si tenemos preguntas o estamos claros en cuanto al significado de cada uno de ellos.
Cough drops.
Cough drops serían como pastillas para la tos, que también pueden tomarse como cough drops, los dulcitos, esos como zorritone or holes that we use for cough. Todos esos van dentro de los cough drops.
Teacher,
okay. Tell me.
Es acetaminophen, la pronunciación.
Acetaminophen. Acetaminophen.
Perdón.
Acetaminophen.
Acetaminophen.
Exactly. It goes like
Thank
that.
Thank you.
Acetaminophen.
Acetaminophen.
Very good. Okay, creo que estamos claros entonces con los demás. Antacid, antiácido, aspirin, aspirina, muscle cream, crema para los músculos. Esta palabra muscle es músculo. Then we have cough syrup, jarabe para la tos. Cough drops, pastillas para la tos. And cold pills, como pastillas frías, or cápsulas. Eye drops, gotas para los ojos. Acetaminophen, acetaminophen, ibuprofen, ibuprofeno. Okay, any questions? No more. Okay, so now we are going to practice by making a short conversation. So here I have some of the expressions that you can use in the conversation. And it starts like person A goes saying, how are you? Or how do you feel? I feel. And then you add, for example, I feel sick. I feel bad. Or I feel terrible. You complete it the way you want it. Then the answer could be, what's the matter? What's wrong? I have a headache, for instance. Or I have a backache. I have the flu. I have a cold. Well, you can take some. And then you add some kind of medication. Vamos a irla completando. Acá usted puede decidir cuál de las dos preguntas utiliza. De igual forma, acá completamos con un adjetivo. Puede ser positivo o puede ser negativo. Nada más tener cuidado con cómo vamos a seguir. Porque si acá digo algo positivo, pues ya no voy a preguntar what's wrong, ¿verdad? I feel great. I feel excellent. Then you don't ask. What's wrong? En ese caso ya no le preguntamos cuál es el problema, right? Sino que tenemos que buscar otra forma de seguir la conversación. Okay? Any questions?
No, teacher.
All right. So now I'm going to send you to the breakout rooms so you can make the conversation with a classmate. You have 3 minutes to complete it and then we come back and we listen to some of the conversations. Okay. So please accept the invitation.
Ah, no, no hay problema. Vamos a realizar la conversación que la teacher enseñó. No sé si la viste, si no la mando al grupo.
Ok, ahorita, aquí la tengo ya. I get it.
Ok, ok. Ahí está bien.
You are A or B?
Um, ¿Quieres empezar tú?
Okay. How are you? How do you feel?
I feel a little sick.
What's the matter? What's wrong?
I have a backache.
Well, you can take aspirin.
Oh, thank you. I'm going to take aspirin.
That's it.
Yes, you take an aspirin. That's right.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome.
So,
entonces la otra persona tiene que decir, I have. Y después, well, you can take, y le vas a recetar una medicina.
You can take.
Ahora sí.
A ver si me recuerdo los nombres. Otra vez entonces. How do you feel?
I feel tired.
What's the matter?
I have been working at the computer all day.
You can take muscle cream?
Yes. Oh. Uh-huh.
That's a great idea.
How do you feel?
Sorry, just let me tell you something. You say with the in the case of cream, you put some cream on, okay? En el caso de cremas, las ponemos, las aplicamos. Entonces decimos put some cream on or put some muscle cream on.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Continue.
Thank you.
Titi.
Sí.
Sí, si mal no recuerdo yo. Sí, o alguna de las medicinas comunes que hemos visto. No sé, acetaminofen, ibuprofen, aspirin.
Do you have any questions?
Aspirin.
Sí, teacher, ¿cómo se dice relajante muscular? Disculpe.
Oh, that could be... no, relajante muscular.
Se puede ocupar el muscle cream.
Yes, I would say, but let me just... find out the word for relajante muscular. Ahorita le digo cómo se dice relajante.
Thank you.
Yeah, muscle relaxant.
Muscle relaxant?
Yes.
Okay, teacher, muscle thank you.
Relaxant.
Entonces, sería I intake. Rest some. ¿Cómo fue? Se me olvidó cómo se dice crema relajante.
Muscle cream.
Muscle relaxant and muscle cream. Sí, cream sería crema para los músculos. Uh-huh. Or muscle relaxant, relajante muscular. Acá lo voy a escribir en el chat por si gustan revisar.
Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome.
Muscle relax.
Ibuprofen.
I know how to work hard. The bird is.
Yeah.
Oh. Híjole,
en el year 2000, en esa batalla yo también, pero era in the year 2000.
How old we were?
No.
Were you?
No, es who old were you in the years 2000?
Ah, sí, perdón, después la cambié, ya me acordé, sí.
Sí, así
sí, tiene razón, ajá. Sí.
Es cierto, ahí batallé, pero que había esa, esa es la que había esa trampita también en esta, y así me salió otra y que la vi yo. ¿Y qué madre pasa? Y así va, pero igual. Pero sí está.
Okay. Where you can take cold drop?
Cold drop? Cold drops?
Uh-huh. Drops and aspirin.
Okay, thank you very much.
Bueno, ya te digo.
Ya estuvo.
Nice to meet you, thank you. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
All right, welcome back. Did you all make a conversation? Yes? All right, pretty good. Do I have any volunteers to say the presentation, to tell the presentation to the class?
Hi, teacher.
Okay, Jasmine, who did you work with? Jasmine, ¿con quién trabajó, Jasmine?
With me.
Okay, Mauricio. With Mauricio. Okay, so go ahead, guys.
Okay. Okay. The ladies first.
How do you feel, Mauricio?
I feel bad.
What's the matter?
I have a flu.
Well, you can take acetaminophen.
Okay, thanks. I do.
Okay, excellent. Thank you, Jasmine and Mauricio.
That's okay, great. You're welcome.
Do I have another pair of volunteers?
Me?
Karen. And who's your pair?
Me, teacher.
I don't remember the name.
Roberto. Okay.
Roberto. Yeah. Sorry, Robert. Uh-huh.
Nah.
So please start now.
How are you?
I feel bad.
What's wrong?
I have stomach hedge.
Oh, well, you can take antacid and you feel better.
Well, thank you. I take antacids.
Okay, pretty good. Thank you, Roberto and Karen.
Okay.
All right, who's next?
Teacher, just one question. What is the difference what's the matter and what's wrong? What is the difference, matter and wrong?
Se pueden utilizar de igual forma. What's the matter? ¿Cuál es el problema? What's wrong? ¿Cuál es el problema o qué está mal? Right? Could use them in any case. You could use them in a similar situations. se utilizan okay. en situaciones similares. Significan básicamente lo mismo.
Ah, okay, okay. Thank you.
All right, you're welcome. Okay, so who's next? See. Lorena, turn on your microphone, please. And who's working with Lorena? Lorena, who's your pair?
Ana Ruth.
Okay, so Ana Ruth and Lorena, go ahead.
Who begins? Ana Ruth. How do you feel, Ana Ruth?
I feel happy.
Oh, really? What? Why?
I'm happy because I am learning a lot of in the English course.
Oh, great. That's excellent.
Okay, pretty well. Excellent, Ana Ruth and Lorena. That was nice. Okay, how about Jose Arturo?
Yes.
And who did you work with?
Raquel.
Me.
Isabel. Okay. All right. Batería. So you can start now.
Yes. Hi, Isabel. How are you?
I feel very sick.
What's wrong?
I have a flu.
Well, you can take aspirin or acetaminophen.
Oh, thank you so much.
You will better.
Thank you.
Very good. Thank you, Jose Arturo and Isabel. Great. And we are missing Joshua. And Joshua, did you work with Laura? Or who did you work with?
Yes.
Oh, Joshua? That was Joshua and Carla. Okay.
Yes.
So
please go ahead with your conversation.
You first, Joshua.
Me. Okay. How do you feel, Carla?
I don't feel well.
Sorry?
I don't feel well.
Okay. I feel well.
I don't feel well.
Sorry, se me está... Creo que me está trabando un poco la conexión.
Oh, okay, don't worry, Joshua, it's fine.
Okay.
All right, so no problem. Thank you, Carla, and thank you, Joshua. And let's see, Laura, who are you working with? ¿Con quién trabajó Laura? Laura Bayona? Okay. All right. So anyways, thank you very much for practicing the conversation. It was a nice practice. Now let's continue by talking about our today's lesson objective. Well, by the end, let me just... Oh, don't worry, Laura. It's okay. Thanks for letting me know. So let's see. Our lesson objective, by the end of this class, you will learn how to use positive and negative imperatives. Additionally, you will also practice a conversation which illustrates how this topic is used in a real life setting. Ahora vamos a hablar un poquito de los imperativos and how to use them. So we are going to start with a short conversation. We are going to listen to the conversation and I want you to identify two things. The first one, who are the speakers? ¿Quiénes son los que están participando en la conversación? ¿Quiénes son los que están platicando? And the second one, what is the conversation about? ¿De qué trata la conversación o de qué están hablando? Who are the speakers and what's the conversation about? So let me just play the conversation. I need you to pay attention and to answer those two questions.
Let's get started by listening.
Can you hear that?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. All right, very good. So now pay attention and identify the answer to those questions. Who are the speakers and what are they talking about?
Into a conversation title, Don't Work Too Hard. Let's listen and practice.
Don't work too hard. Hello, Ms. West. How are you today?
Not so good.
So what's wrong exactly?
I'm exhausted.
Why are you so tired?
I don't know. I just can't sleep at night.
Okay, let's take a look at you. I'm going to give you some pills. Take one pill every night after dinner.
Okay.
And don't drink coffee, tea, or soda.
Anything else?
Yes. Don't work too hard.
All right. Thanks, Dr. Young.
The conversation that we just heard illustrates the conversation between a doctor and a...
Okay. Pretty good. So did you identify the speakers? Who are the speakers in the conversation?
Dr. Young.
Dr. Young and... and a patient, right? It's a conversation between a doctor and a patient, exactly.
Yes.
And what are they talking about? What's the matter?
She can't sleep.
I'm tired. Her,
what is it?
Her patient is exhausted. Yeah.
Okay, the patient is exhausted. She can't sleep. And her name is Miss West, as Laura mentions, right? Yes. So pretty good. Let me just show you the conversation now. So here we have it. Take some seconds to read it and let me know if there is any new word for you or any word that you would like to know the pronunciation of. A ver, acá tengo la conversación, la podemos ver y si tenemos preguntas acerca del vocabulario o de la pronunciación, me dicen. Any questions?
No.
Okay. So far so good?
All is clear.
What is it? Any questions?
No question for me.
No one.
Okay, nice. Okay. All right, so let me just tell you about this word, Ms. So this is part of the titles that we have in English. And then we have four different ones. Tenemos cuatro títulos distintos. We have Mr., that is for men. And it doesn't matter if they are married or not married, right? Se usa para hombres, no importa si son casados o si no están casados. Y de igual forma, los títulos en inglés se utilizan solamente con el apellido. For example, if I want to call Mauricio a Mr., then I say Mr. Trujillo. Mr. Trujillo, sorry. And then also Roberto would be Mr. Jimenez. or in the case of Jose Arturo, Mr. Ramirez, right? So that is for men. Then for women, we have three different ones. Para mujer tenemos tres títulos distintos. El primero es el que tenemos acá, que es Ms. Ms. Ese se utiliza para mujeres que pueden estar casadas o no casadas. Si no estoy muy segura de si la persona a la que me estoy refiriendo está casada o no, entonces utilizo este, Ms. Ms. Luego tengo el título Miss, Miss, que es para mujeres solteras. So if you are not married, you are a Miss, right? And the same, you use it together with a last name. De igual forma se utiliza con un apellido. Miss Mendoza, for instance. Or Miss, let's see, do we have any single women here? Let's see, Carla, are you married?
Yes.
Sorry, I couldn't hear you, Carla. Are you married?
Yes, I am.
Okay, you're married, okay. Good. So you're a Mrs. And let's see, Karen, are you married?
Yes, I'm married.
You're married too? Okay, nice. And let's see, do we have any single women here?
Yes, you.
Just me? Okay. So, Miss Mendoza, then. En la otra clase solo tenía mujeres solteras y acá solo mujeres casadas, okay? So that's interesting. So, anyways, in the case of married women, we have Mrs. Para las mujeres casadas, utilizamos Mrs. So Laura says she's single. So, Laura would be Miss Bayona. Miss Bayona, okay? And then all the others, like, let's see, Lorena, Mrs. Peña, right?
Yes.
Then we would have... Let's see. Okay, so you use them that way. We have four in Jasmine single too. Okay, there are a couple of single Miss. Okay, so in that case, we use Miss. Miss Perez, Miss Bayona. And if you are not sure, you use Miss. Fíjese en la diferencia de pronunciación entre Miss y Miss. A ver, voy a escribirlo por acá para que lo podamos entender mejor. Esta, entonces, esta primera que tenemos acá es para mujeres casadas o no casadas cuando no estamos seguros. Y esta para mujeres solteras. Esta se pronuncia con un sonido de Z al final, like Miss, Miss. And this one is Miss, Miss, with S, Miss. ¿Ok? Y luego la que les mencionaba para mujeres casadas, Mrs. And then for men, we have Mr. There we are. Any questions? No questions. Ok, so let's...
Miss?
Tell me.
Sí, es Miss y Mrs.
El...
¿Cómo se escuchó? ¿Se escuchó la diferencia? ¿No se escuchó la diferencia cuando lo dije?
Sí, nada más hay que hacer un poquito de énfasis. Este suena como, como una Z en inglés, like Miss, con ese sonidito Miss. De Z. Miss. 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 Y este sí es con S, Miss, Miss. Okay. Repeat, please. Miss.
Miss.
Okay, so keep on practicing. All right, nice. So now it's time to practice the conversation. Let's see, do we have any volunteers to read the conversation?
Me.
Sorry, who's that?
Karen.
Oh, okay, Karen.
Me.
Karen and Roberto.
Yeah.
Okay, Roberto, you're the doctor. Start, please.
Okay. Hello, Miss Wes. How are you today?
Well, not so good.
So what wrong exactly?
I'm exhausted.
Why are you so tired?
I don't know. I just can't sleep at night.
Okay, let's take a look at you. I am going to give you some pills. Take one pill every night after dinner.
Okay.
And don't drink coffee, tea, or soda.
Anything else?
Yes, don't work too hard.
All right. Thanks, Dr. Young.
Okay.
Okay, very good, Karen and Roberto. Thank you. Do we have another pair to read the conversation?
Hi.
Okay, so that was, let's see. Perdón, me dicen los nombres, please, porque no logré identificar.
Brina.
So that is Mauricio and
Lorena.
Lorena, okay. So Lorena, you're the doctor this time.
Okay. Hello, Miss West. How are you today?
And I am Miss West.
Yes.
It's really bad. So, no, not so good.
So, what's wrong exactly?
I'm exhausted.
Why are you so tired?
I don't know. I just can't sleep at night.
Okay, let's take a look at you. I'm going to give you some pills. Take one pill every night after dinner.
Okay.
And don't drink coffee, tea, or soda.
Anything else?
Yes, don't work so hard.
All right. Thank you, Dr. John.
It's
okay.
Because of the concert.
So thank you, Lorena. Thank you, Mauricio. That was nice.
Okay, you're welcome.
Let's have another pair to read. Let's see who's participating.
Yeah.
Jasmine and
me.
And that is Arturo, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, Arturo, you're the doctor.
Okay. Hello, Miss West. How are you today?
Not so good.
So, what's wrong with sexually?
I'm exhausted.
Why are you so tired?
I don't know. I just can't sleep at night.
Okay. Let's take a look at you. I'm going to give you some pills. Take one pill every night after dinner.
Okay.
And don't drink coffee, tea, or soda.
Anything else?
Yes. Don't work too hard.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Young.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Jasmine and Arturo. All right, now I need you to repeat, please. Everybody, repeat. Wrong.
Wrong.
Wrong. Wrong.
Exactly.
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 Exactly. Exhausted.
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 Tired.
Tired.
Tired. Tired.
Tired.
Tired. Very good. Now say take. Take.
Take.
Take. Pills.
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 Okay. Tea.
Tea.
Traspasarlo.
Tea. So we have coffee, tea, or soda. Repeat, please.
So
coffee,
tea, or soda.
Anything.
Anything.
Anything else.
Anything else.
All right.
Anything else.
All right. Okay, excellent. So now let's talk a little bit about imperatives. Vamos a hablar un poquito de los imperativos.
No.
Acá los podemos encontrar en tres ocasiones. El primero es este, take one pill every night. Take one pill every night. Vemos como la doctora le está diciendo a la paciente qué debe hacer. Tómese una pastilla cada noche. Take one pill every night. Es como si le estuviese ordenando algo, ¿verdad? Dando una orden. Then we have don't drink coffee. Don't drink coffee, tea or soda. No tome café, té o soda. So something you don't have to do, right? The next one is don't work too hard. Don't work too hard. No trabaje tanto, no trabaje mucho. So we see in these examples that we use imperatives to give an order, a warning, a suggestion, an instruction, or advice. Vamos a utilizar los imperativos para dar órdenes, recomendaciones, sugerencias, algún tipo de indicación, o también lo utilizamos para dar consejos, like in the case of doctors. Also, another thing that we need to know about imperatives is that we use the infinitive or base form of the verb without to. Otra cosa a tomar en cuenta acerca de los imperativos es que utilizamos el verbo en su forma infinitiva o su forma base sin agregar el to. No decimos to take, sino que únicamente take. Take some pills. And then also notice that there is no subject. También notemos que no utilizamos ningún sujeto. A diferencia de las otras oraciones donde iniciamos ya sea con un nombre propio como Mary, Charles, or Justin, o con un sujeto, un pronombre como I, you, we, they, or any other. En este caso de los imperativos no lo utilizamos. Porque en realidad cuando usamos imperativos nos estamos refiriendo a la persona con la que estamos hablando o a las personas con las que estamos hablando.
En directo.
Exactly. So, for example, here I have, eat healthy, eat healthy. Se lo digo a usted, ¿verdad? Coma sano o saludable, coma saludable, right? Eat healthy. Or drink lots of water, drink lots of water. Tome mucha agua. Another thing to notice is that we make the imperative negative by adding do not or don't before the verb. Para hacer los imperativos negativos, solamente agregamos el do not o el don't al inicio de la oración, antes del verbo. For example, here, don't eat healthy, in this case. Si lo quisiéramos hacer negativo, solo le agregamos el don't acá antes de eat, y sería don't eat healthy. Or, here we have more examples, don't eat much candy. Don't eat much candy. No coma muchos dulces. Don't touch. Don't touch. No tocar o no toque. And a third thing to take into account is that to make the imperative more polite, we add please. Para que el imperativo no suene tanto como una orden, sino que suene un poquito más amable, utilizamos la palabra please, que se puede agregar al final, como en be quiet, please, be quiet, please. Or you can use it at the beginning of the sentence, like please copy this. please, copy this. Acá podemos agregar el please para que se escuche más amable. Se puede agregar al final utilizando una coma y luego el please. O lo podemos agregar al inicio también. Do you have any questions about this?
No, it's okay.
It's okay? All right, nice. So now I want to hear some examples from you. Let's suppose that we are parents and we are saying some things to our kids, right? So we are giving some orders to our kids. Supongamos que en el caso de los padres, ¿verdad? Que pasamos diciéndole a los niños que hagan esto, que no hagan el otro, and so on. So tell me some imperatives for kids. Let's see, for example, Jose Arturo, do you have one?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Don't take my tools.
Don't take my tools. Okay, very good. Roberto, tell me another example, please.
Be careful.
Okay, be careful. Okay.
Yeah.
Excellent. Lorena, do you have another example?
Don't take my clothes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Karen, give me another example, please.
Don't put your hands in your mouth.
Okay, that's a good one. Carla, I think you were going to say something.
Yes, be quiet, please.
Be quiet, please. Mm-hmm. That's a good example.
Don't run.
Yes, don't run. Very good. Noemi, do you have another example?
Don't eat much bread.
Okay, nice. Ana Ruth.
Can I speak with
school? Sit down, please.
Sit down, please. All right, nice. Mauricio, do you have another one?
Sorry. Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it. Very good. Then Joshua.
Turn off the TV.
Turn off the TV. Yes, great. Isabel, give me another example, please.
Don't move these boxes.
Okay, don't move these boxes. Very good, thank you. And Laura, you're missing. Maybe in the chat, Laura. Do the homework. Okay, nice. Great example. Let's see, I think Karen, you're missing, right?
Hi.
Did you make an example already?
Don't sit over there.
Okay, nice. Very good. And Jasmine, did you already participate?
Don't make noise.
Don't make noise. Very good. Okay, very nice. So that is how we use the imperatives. De esa forma usamos los imperativos para decir algunas cosas que debemos y que no debemos hacer. en ciertos momentos o en ciertos lugares. Entonces, siempre recordar, inician con el verbo, no utilizamos sujeto. Y luego para el negativo agregamos el don't. Al inicio también se puede utilizar la forma completa, do not, la forma larga. Do not eat much candy, que sería como un poco más serio, un poco más formal, ¿verdad? Como en el caso de los museos, los zoológicos o estos lugares así, podemos encontrar a veces los cartelitos con reglas. Y ahí podría haber esa forma, do not use your cell phone, do not bring any liquids, and so on, right? Y normalmente, pues, en conversación lo utilizamos como don't. Y luego agregar el please para sonar un poquito más amables. All right, any questions about this? No? So far so good?
No.
Okay, so that's all for today's class. Thank you very much for paying attention and for participating. I'll see you tomorrow. Take care. Have a good night.
Okay.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Good night, everybody.
Thank you.